Good morning everyone. So today we are going to start a new chapter. In this chapter we are going to study Eulerian graphs as well as Hamiltonian graphs. To begin with, let us consider the following problem. So consider any one of the graphs and the question is, can you draw them without lifting pencil from the paper and without repeating any lines? Three graphs are there. We need to try it for each one of them. So when you try it, you find that for the first one, it's possible as follows. So you start with this edge, then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12, and you reach back to 1. For the second one, you start from here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So you started from this vertex and you end up at this vertex. And for the last one, it's not possible. So for the first two graphs, it is possible that you manage to trace the whole graph without lifting your pencil and without repeating any edge. The vertices got repeated. At the same time, you will observe that in the first one, it is start and end at the same vertex. While the second one, it is start with the vertex and end at the another vertex. Now we can define the Eulerian graphs. So let G be any graph. Recall the concept of walk. So it's a sequence of vertices and edges, and then we discuss trail, which is sequence of vertices and edges such that the edges should not get repeated. So a trail of G that contains each edge of G is called the Eulerian trail, and closed trail is a circuit. So a circuit of G that contains every edge of G is called an Eulerian circuit of G. If the graph is an Eulerian circuit, we call it an Eulerian graph. So you can see that in the previous slide, the first one is the Eulerian graph because it has a closed trail covering all the edges. Which one of the following is Eulerian? Again, please do try first by yourself, and then you can observe that the first one is Eulerian because you can see the cycles. You can start from the middle one and try to cover each cycle one by one. In the second one, if you try it, you would be able to trace the graph, but the starting and the ending vertex are different. But as the size of the graph increase, we need some mathematical method to identify if the graph is Eulerian or not. So Euler gave this theorem which says that a connected graph is Eulerian if and only if every vertex has even degree. Very, very interesting result and the important result. And now you can see that the first graph is, this graph is Eulerian because each one has even degree. All the vertices, whichever you pick, you can see it has an even degree and therefore the graph is Eulerian. A connected graph has an Eulerian trail if and only if all except two vertices in G have an even degree. So from this graph, if you move to this graph, then you can see that I have only deleted this vertex. And therefore, there are two vertices of odd degree, 3 and 3, while all other vertices have even degree. And therefore, the first graph is Eulerian, while the second graph has an Eulerian trail. It's not Eulerian, but it has an Eulerian trail. So let's try to discuss the proof of the following theorem. First part is quite easy to follow. It says that if G has an Eulerian circuit, which means G is Eulerian, then we need to prove that the degrees are even. Please do think by yourself that why it is happening. So graph is Eulerian, it means it has an Eulerian circuit, which means there is a closed trail starting and ending at a vertex while covering all the edges. So whenever you visit an edge, whenever you visit a vertex, you can see that there is an edge going in and there is an edge going out. Because this is only way you can reach back to the same vertex. It means that degree of this vertex is twice the number of times it is visited, and which is always an even number. The only difference is in the case of the initial vertex, because you start from here and then in the end you come back here. But in that case also the degree would be even. So degree of u is 2 times ku, where ku denotes the number of the times you visit the vertex u. And for the initial vertex, degree is 2 times ks minus 1, which is again an even number. Therefore, if the graph is Eulerian, the degrees are even, very easy to follow. The next side is, if the vertex has an even degree, then prove that there exists an Eulerian circuit. You can draw a very simple graph like this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there is an even degree and therefore the graph is Eulerian. But how do you prove it? Can you think of decomposing the graph into edge disjoint cycles? And if it can be decomposed into edge disjoint cycles, can you say the graph is Eulerian? For example, this one. So you can see that it can be decomposed into two edge disjoint cycles. And the approach which you can use is that you can identify a cycle which is 1, 2, 3. Then you delete all the edges of this cycle. So you have the remaining cycle as 4, 5, 1, which can be written as 1, 2, 4, 5 and 1, and then you can replace it here. So you will have 1, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3 and 1. And this is a closed trail. So it means to prove it, we are going to devise an algorithm. So it is start with an arbitrary vertex V, and then since the graph is connected, so there is always a path. So you choose any path whichever you want, and since each vertex has even degree, it means it has at least one cycle. So when you choose a vertex, you will reach or you come back to the same vertex. Something like this. So you start with A, you go to F, then D, and then you come back to A. Now delete all the edges of the obtained cycle from the given graph. After deleting the edges, when we are deleting the edges, we are not deleting the vertices. But yes, after deleting the edges, if it is an isolated vertex, we can delete it. Now since each vertex has an even degree, there was a cycle and therefore it happened. Now choose any of the vertex from this cycle which still have a positive degree after deleting this edge. So let's say that I choose the another cycle F, E, D, C, F. So this is the idea. I started with A, F, D, A, then I replaced F by F, E, D, C, F, and that gives me a closed trail starting from A and ending at A. And since we are deleting edges each time, which ensures that in the end we have covered all the edges such that there is no repetition of the edge. So now from this graph, delete AFD, also delete the edges, these four edges and these three edges. Now only remaining part is ABC. So you can consider it as the cycle whichever you want. For example, if you say at BACB, then you have to, B is not there. So you have to consider either A or C and replace it accordingly. So you consider it as CBAC and replaced C, and that gives you finally the required closed trail while covering all the edges, which is an Eulerian trail. So the proof comes with the construction. We provided an algorithm which guarantees that in the end we'll have an Eulerian trail, and hence the result is proved. So from this part, it can be easily concluded that a graph is Eulerian if and only if it is a disjoint union of cycles in G. In the next class, you can try to think over this problem, which we are going to discuss in the next class. So find an Eulerian circuit for the following graph starting at vertex B, and think of another algorithm to find the Eulerian circuit. Thank you.